Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and today I'm telling you about my Kybella treatment that was 4 days ago now. So I'm going to tell you about that, a little bit about my experience and what people can expect. But in thinking about it, I've been seeing a lot more on Instagram and YouTube about mesotherapy, and that's really what led to LipoDissolve, which then turned into Kybella in this country. I want to talk briefly about that so we remember where it came from. 2002 to 2003, I went to France and learned mesotherapy. And meso means middle, and so middle layer of skin. And we were all wondering, why did the French women look so good? They were thin and they were smoking like chimneys, but they still had beautiful skin. And Pistor is a guy who developed some of the mesotherapy techniques still in use today. And putting nutrients like niacinamide, DMAE, vitamin C, and all kinds of nutrients, and non-cross-linked hyaluronic acid by nipaging it into the skin. And I'm seeing that all on Instagram now and YouTube, and it's making a bit of a comeback. Restylane skin boosters, I'm gonna talk about that next month and show you a treatment. All of those things exist, and from there came LipoDissolve. And LipoDissolve spread around the world, but it got a bad rap, mainly because it was being done in places where it shouldn't have been done by untrained people, and there were bacteria. Even at one point in, I think it was around 2007 in Brazil, there was these odd mycoplasma bacteria that were almost only seen in people getting LipoDissolve mesotherapy. So that was phosphatidylcholine and deoxycholate, so PCDC. Now we have Kybella, which is deoxycholate. I think it's much cleaner than what we used way back when. I think it's very effective. There's still a group of people that I talked to in Europe, even last month, that feel like you need some PC mixed in with the DC, so you need some phosphatidylcholine for it to work that well. So you can see it's still being used around the world, even where Kybella isn't approved. There's just not a lot of comparative studies that I've ever found. Maybe some of our subscribers will shed some light. So here we are with Kybella, and let's talk a little bit about the treatment, how it's evolved. I treated underneath the chin, and also on the face at the angle of the mouth. And you can see it's day four and there's some swelling. I'm very aware of it, especially if you look down, you can see it. And then at the edge of the mouth. And so using it on the face is something that can be done in selected patients. What is it? You get initial pain, you get swelling pretty dramatically for a couple days. And then the patient, me in this case, well, I'll be aware of it for at least 2 weeks, and it's important to know, because for viewers or people around you talking to you or eating, drinking with you, they might not notice it after 4 or 5 days, but patients are very aware. When we're using it on the face, of course, there's the nerve that can affect the smile. I've seen one patient with that. It's not that common, and it always comes back. So when they smile, it can be a little crooked, and that usually starts at day 5 to 10, but it goes away at 3 to 4 weeks. There'll be some numbness, which of course I feel now, and that can last up to 4 to 6 weeks. It just feels a little different in the treated areas. So swelling, the nerve problem, and the sensation are very common. Bruising's not that common. It can occur, maybe 10% of the patients, 1 in 10. When it does, I find it's a bit dramatic. Cannula and Kybella, you'll see that being done. I'm not a huge fan. It can be done. It's not going to make that big of a difference. I've done it on several comparative. The needle is quick, it's easy, and it works very well, and you can be pointed, especially if you're treating the pregel or the oral commissure like I did in my case. You want to be very specific because you do not want to remove fat medial to the fold. You only want to remove it at the fold. This area I'm very careful with because a lot of people can't take the swelling. It's an area that's already larger because we're treating it. And then the patient is going to see that for maybe 4 to 6 weeks. So if someone's going away on a trip or they're very conscious about the downturn of the mouth, you might not treat that patient with this product. But I find it works well in the select patient who understands it. But whenever you're dissolving fat on the face, if you choose to do it, you really need great pictures because people forget what they look like, and you don't want to dissolve it in the wrong area because you'll be filling it then for life. But you want to just make sure you're staying lateral to the fold, not medial. So that's a fair bit about Kybella. I'll update some pictures. I'll pull some pictures from the archive, see if I have any of myself, and maybe show some before and afters. Really, when do we see results? Okay, so by 4 to 5 weeks, a patient might start to see some results, and that's when they might get retreated. But for full results, it's really 6 months, so I'll wait to 6 months to have a look at it. But of course, you'll be watching the videos here. You'll be able to judge for yourself. So Kybella is a great product. The jawline and rejuvenation is in, and Kybella is a big part of sculpting the jawline and the lower facial region for me in my practice. Join us on Instagram. Join us here in this YouTube channel. Let me hear your comments below and follow us for continued helpful tips to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.